Now let me talk a little bit more about the permutation matrices. If you have in R2, if you want to swap the first row and second row, this is the permutation matrix. I took the identity matrix and swapped the first row and second row. Its determinant, as you can see, is a 0, minus 1, it's minus 1. If I apply this twice, I'll get the original one back, because I'm swapping and then swapping them back again. So I'll get the original one back. And for that reason, its inverse is the same as itself. And such matrices are called involutory. Similarly, in R3, I can have more complicated exchanges. I can do the first and second, second and third and fourth. All those things are involutory, because if you do it once more, you get back to the original one. But if you do multiple row exchanges, it is not involutory. If you do it twice, you don't get back to the original one. These single permutation matrices are the ones that you will consider in Gaussian elimination. Double permutations are interesting to know, but we will not be using it directly. If you want to do a double permutation, you will do it in two steps, two single permutations.